Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. I'm Ashley, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my tips on how I keep an organized home. Tip one is declutter, declutter, declutter. I cannot say this enough. But if you're like me and you get declutter happy sometimes, make sure you talk to your significant other or your spouse before you go declutter crazy. So if you're the kind of person that gets stressed or overwhelmed by the word declutter, I say start with once a week in a small space. Whether it's a drawer, your medicine cabinet, or a shelf, you'll be surprised at what you can do in a small space only once a week and how much it actually motivates you to want to keep going further. Or maybe you're the kind of person who is emotionally tied to your things, or you associate certain memories with your items. For example, I recently did a declutter in our closet. I'll link the video in the description box below, and I have what's called a memory box. So any of the things that I tie memories to, whether it was our wedding, our baby's birth, things like that, those go in that box. So it's been placed in the top of my closet. It's clean, organized, decluttered, and out of the way. Maybe there are items around your home that you have a hard time parting with, whether you spent money on, you loved 4 years ago, but now you don't love so much. When I am trying to declutter my home, my first thought is, how is this item benefiting my home or my family? Have I used it in 3 months? Have I used it in 6 months? Have I used it in 3 weeks? I try to think about all of these things and how it is practical for me in the situation and the season I'm in right now. Doing these small things over the years have definitely made it easier to keep my home better organized. Tip two, containers and bins. If you know me, you know I am a sucker for containers, storage, baskets, bins. I have them all over my house and I use them for multiple things. And yes, I love me a good Pinterest organization board as much as the next person, but it's not always budget friendly. In the beginning of my organization journey, I started out with Tupperwares that maybe had missing lids, jars, and even old boxes that I would cut the flaps off of. So I say, get creative and use what you have around your home. Shop your home first and see what you've got. Start there and then move forward. So over the years, I've discovered I am more of a visual person. If it looks pretty and looks put together or color coordinated, I'm more likely to keep it organized. I have tons of different types of organization bins all over my home, from my pantry to the kids' closet to my bathroom drawers. I have a wide range of organizational bins in my home, from higher end to pretty cheap. So if you're on a tight budget and you really want things to look cohesive and pretty, my first suggestion would be Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree has tons of color coordinated bins, all different shapes and sizes to fit your needs, and only for a dollar. Maybe you're wanting to step it up a little bit, want something pretty in wicker or wood. I've gotten tons of my bins from Dollar General, ranging from $12 to $4, that have fit my spaces so well and keep everything looking so pretty and definitely fit my farmhouse style that I'm looking for. And if price really isn't an issue and you want to take it up a notch, maybe you want something that is more durable, is going to last a really long time, Target and Home Goods have rows and rows of organizational bins that can fit any area of your home. So get creative and find new ways to keep yourself and your home more organized, prevent your home from getting messy, and staying looking nice and tidy. My next tip is labeling. I find that I keep things more organized when I label items for myself and also for my kids. Why do you think teachers label their entire classrooms? It teaches your children that everything has a home and draws them back to those places to actually put them away. And if your kids are constantly asking you where stuff is, I'm not saying this is magic, people, we're still working on it, but it makes it very obvious for them, and then they know exactly where to put it back at cleanup time. I was recently gifted a Silhouette and it has been a game changer in our home. But maybe you don't have access or the budget for something like that. Amazon has budget-friendly labeling kits for every area of your home. My next tip is find a place for everything in your home where you use it. I'm gonna be honest, sometimes I can get a little lazy, and if I have to go to the other side of the house to put something up, most likely it's gonna end up on the counter or in a junk drawer. So, for example, we have two different medicine bins for our children, one in our bathroom and one in the kitchen. And we all know that kids can get sick at any point in time, even in the middle of the night. I would run to my bathroom and then leave all of my supplies in the kitchen, and they would never get put back. Now I have a specific bin in the kitchen cabinet for kids' allergy medicines, band-aids, or pain and fever medicines for those middle of the night emergencies. So that saying that everything has a home, trust me, it works. My last tip is your mindset. Find new ways to change your mindset about how to get organized. I love things to look clean and organized, but I'm not a naturally organized person. I'm typically a drop and go kind of person. I used to think that I had to have the perfect basket, or maybe I just didn't have enough space. My home was too small, and all of these were just excuses. I had to stop blaming it on not having the skills or not having enough space and just stop procrastinating. I don't like getting frustrated over small things, especially when I could have prevented them in the first place. I was getting overwhelmed and stressed just because I couldn't find nail clippers or a hairbrush. And overall, I really do want to set a good example for my kids and their future homes and give them great tips that they can carry on into their adult lives. So just changing my mindset about getting organized has completely transformed our home and our lives and has definitely made things less stressful. So if you're wanting to transform your home, try these tips for a more tidy and organized space. You won't regret it. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video and I hope that some of these tips can help you get your home more organized. And if you like this video, I'd love for you to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel and join my YouTube family. Here on my channel, I share tons of cleaning motivation, organization, decluttering videos, and all of the mom life in between. I hope today's video can help motivate and encourage you to get your journey started in organization and decluttering your home. I hope that I was able to encourage you guys in some way today and help give you ideas on how to start organizing your home. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.